Hey guys, it's Andrew again. Welcome back to another video review from my EME 2040 course. For this particular video review, we're going to be reviewing collaborative tools that are used inside the classroom. And I decided to choose one of my personal favorites that I used to chat with my friends, and that is Skype. And Skype is very popular as well because it's used inside the classroom. So I'm going to go and dig deep a little bit about how to use it inside the classroom. What are the pros and cons? What grades are intended for? And all that mumbo jumbo, but we're going to jump right into it. And I decided to add a little bit of a nostalgic feel before we start with this presentation, where I added one of the original slogans from Skype when it started out, and that is take a deep breath. Let's jump right in. Okay, so before I start talking a little bit about Skype and what it does, how it works and all that, I want to say, what is Skype intended for? Like, who is intended for? What grades, you know, as to what school level is it intended for? So the good thing about Skype is that it's greatly intended for grades from 1 through 12. So as little as 6 years old, which is perfect to use inside the classroom because it makes it very user-friendly for all types of collaboration that students can connect with other students and also can connect with their teachers easily. So that's good to know because we all know that safety is important, especially when you're gonna be navigating responsibly through the digital world. So it's important to take these things in mind because if not, it can have some serious repercussions. Okay, so what's the big idea? How does Skype work? All right, so most of us are probably already familiar with Skype. We are familiar that it's a very nice way to connect with friends and all that. Even though it's not used a lot now, it's all about FaceTime, it's all about WhatsApp chatting, and it's all about using different social media platforms to actually engage in either voice calling or video calling with our friends. So how does it work? So Skype allows users to engage in digital communication through videos and voice calls, very similar to what we use today. For the most part, it's free of charge, so you don't have to pay a cent. But if you want some additional features, such as sending SMS messages with Skype or engaging in group video calls so you can have more people in the chat, there's usually a subscription where you have to pay. It's not very much, I believe, but for the most part, when it comes to just video chatting with two people like you would do in FaceTime or you would use in other types of social media platforms to talk to your friend or friends, it's free. So another good thing about Skype and how to use it is the fact that Skype is connected with Microsoft. So you can either make an account with Skype itself and have a Skype handle name that you can create yourself, or you can log in through Facebook, or you can also log in through Microsoft if you have a Microsoft account. So that's a really good way. And once you transition into signing in, it makes it easier for everybody else because what you do is that you can sync your contacts. And so if you have a contacts that have Skype, they'll pop up there. If you have contacts, your friends on Facebook, you can sync them in right there and you can talk to them on Skype, or anybody that you're connected with in Microsoft, you know, for Xbox, all types of Microsoft computers, Windows, if you have Microsoft Teams and all that, you could just sync all your friends, all your contacts in there, and you can also use to communicate with in Skype. So just like so other social media platforms, so if you've seen Instagram and if you use Facebook, you know that there's a little green light that pops up next to your friend's name, which usually indicates that they're active at that moment. So what you can do there, when you see that little green light, Skype has that as well, that means that your friends are active on Skype and they're ready to receive your call, which is pretty cool. Because a lot of other applications do not necessarily tell you when your friends are active or when they're ready to receive your call. So if that therefore increases the chances that you can talk to your friends a little bit more because they're active online. Okay, so teach us something, teach. So the point of this video is to see how Skype is used inside the classroom. Okay, so how does this shape education today? So Skype has implemented an excellent resource. It's called Skype in the Classroom. I've never used it, so I can't really speak about my experiences on it, but I can tell you a little bit about it. So the good thing with Skype in the Classroom, teachers are able to create and use lesson plans with Skype in the Classroom as a way to engage students in digital collaboration, digital citizenship, computational thinking. So that's a good thing of it. Also, they can feature classrooms that want to connect with other learning partners. So you can basically post your entire classroom or use other classrooms to just kind of merge in together and use that so you can use different resources that are around the globe pretty much. So another fun interactive thing about Skype and Skype inside the classroom is that they have this little feature. It's called Mystery Skype. So this goes in hand with things that are in the lesson plans typically. So teachers can get together and two classes can join in together to solve mysteries within the lesson plan. So you can have teacher A and teacher B come up with a little activity in class that is fun and interactive for students. And they can say, hey, you can merge your class into it. I can merge my class into it. Let's collaborate together so our students can work together. So that's a good thing about Skype. And it's a little thing that's called Mystery Skype. It's only exclusively for Skype inside the classroom, but it's great if you think about it. A very practical way to also use Skype, and this goes hand in hand with a lot of things, because I said Skype is not only used in education, it's used in a lot of things, personal chat, and Skype also has different things like Skype Business, where you can conduct business meetings if you work for corporate America, or if you're in the workplace and you just need to get in contact with your boss or your other coworkers and all that. And this all goes hand in hand to something where Skype can be used. It has an excellent feature where teachers in Skype inside the classroom, just like Skype Business or just Skype Personal Chat, can invite far off guest speakers. So sometimes when you want to talk to somebody who's in the education field or whatever field that you teach as a teacher, you can invite them because, you know, travel can cost, logistics can be a problem. So you can make everybody's life easier by just video conferencing with that person, that guest speaker that you want inside the classroom, so they can be able to get video discussions inside the class if they can't be there in person. Of course, it's not the same of like being there in person and talking to the students and all that, but still, it creates a little bit of a personal touch and thus enrich students' learning to certain points. Okay, now, friend, what's the catch? All right, so Skype in the classroom sounds all really cool. It sounds awesome, right, guys? You can use it for anything, personal chat, in the classroom, business. Okay, so there's got to be something. Where's the catch? Now, I'm not going to use the cliche. There's no catch because there is a catch. So let's go over a little bit of the pros and cons and all that. First of all, let's talk about the goods because we like Skype. So that's what we're doing here. So cha-ching, it's free to use. So you save a lot of money compared to some things that require a subscription off the bat. So just like I said, you don't have to pay money to use Skype when you want to do certain things. So some things do require a subscription right off the bat where you have to actually pay for using it, just the basic version. So that's a good thing about Skype. You don't have to pay to use the basic version of it or just talking to your friends or using Skype Business. So you're offsetting some of the costs there. It has a lot of interactive features to use inside the classroom. So other thing, like I said before about Mystery Skype, you can merge in two classrooms from a lesson plan mystery activity that you have. That teachers made with for class specifically to participate in, so two classes together. So that's the good thing about it. You can use those interactive features. Also, the fact that you can invite, like I said before, far off guest speakers to come and say have video discussions. So that's something that a lot of other platforms that involve voice and video calling do not have necessarily. Another pro is that you can share screens and send files during a video call, which makes it very suitable and simple inside the classroom. So if you use Skype before, you know that you can share a screen with a friend and be like, hey, bro, let me show you a real quick, cool YouTube video. And you just go real quick and you show them the YouTube video because you shared your screen using Skype. It's the same thing if you're going to use Skype in the classroom. You are able to share screens or send files with your students, kind of like a Class Dojo or Edmodo kind of thing. So it's pretty much, like I said, there's various resources, Microsoft Teams, Google Hangouts, so on and so forth. Now, the catch, cons, what is going on here? The program has been known to get a little bit notoriously buggy, so there could be some technical difficulties that could just present themselves out of the sudden, which can cause a call to drop out of nowhere. So you can be in a call with somebody or far off guest speaker out of nowhere, just drops. Or connectivity can become very poor. Now, there is a way to kind of go through around this con as a way that the pro can outweigh the con, in the sense that if you have high quality video equipment in the classroom, then you are minimizing the, you know, you're minimizing the risk that this can happen. So I'm not saying that it can't happen. It could happen, but, you know, as if you have better quality equipment than other people do, if that makes some sort of sense, it doesn't really happen as much as you think. Okay, so the second con, and this can go kind of like so many ways. So it has a 69% privacy rate. Now, for some people, you can say, oh, 69% privacy rate. That's actually not bad. That's a pretty high number. So it's pretty safe, I guess, right? Yeah, but you still have a 31% of a chunk that's kind of left out, which affects safety in a certain way. So for example, content can be shared with untrusted users, including strangers or other adults that the user that is using, the friendly user that's using Skype may not know. So your profile information is shared. Other things that you are sharing in Skype are shared. So due to this, like I said, this is intended for students that are 1 through 12th grade. So we are talking about 6-year-olds. So let's say these young, you know, these younger users who are not familiar with how to deal with this, or how to navigate the digital world safely, this becomes a problem. And it's just crazy. It's astonishing how you can think, hey, we're using this really safely, but at the same time, a lot of things can happen. So you got to be careful. So this is why I decided to list this as a con, because it is what it is. 69%, it's still not close to 100. So there's going to be some safety risks that are associated with this. Okay, so can somebody spell ISTE? So as a way to conclude, a lot of those things that we talked about in the presentation, this conforms to most of the ISTE standards for students. So Skype being used inside the classroom highlights a lot of the ISTE standards that must be met for students to navigate the digital world responsibly. So we have a lot of ISTE standards for students. We have about 8. I decided to choose these 3 because these 3 are actually the ones that resonate the most with Skype. So number 1, we have empowered learners. So students leverage technology, take an active role in choosing, achieving, and demonstrating competency in their learning goals informed by the learning sciences. So students are learning and being exposed to this type of technology so they can take the lead. And they're not only using it inside the classroom, but they can use it outside the classroom to collaborate with other friends. But as a matter of fact, like I said, they can share files or send files. So they got to be careful what they do. And so they learn through this. They become empowered learners through this. Another one is digital citizen. Students recognize the rights, responsibilities, and opportunities of living, learning, and working in an interconnected digital world and the active model in ways that are safe, legal, and ethical. This goes hand in hand with being an empowered learner. You're learning how to navigate through the digital world safely. So you are not at risk to sharing your profile information completely, and you just know how to communicate with others. So if by chance, not that it's going to happen, by chance, you have another untrusted user that you don't know that just gets a hold of your information or asks for information because they want to communicate with you in Skype, you learn and you teach these students from a very young age on not to give this private information out, how to use the idea of media privacy very safely. And the last ISTE standard for students that I decided to use was Global Collaborator. So Global Collaborator goes a little bit more hand in hand with what Skype basically is. You not only collaborate with people domestically, but internationally as well. So this goes hand in hand with the whole thing of Mystery Skype, where you merge two classrooms together, but at the same time, you can talk to guest speakers off. So students learn a lot about collaborating with others around the globe and learning how to be safe also in the digital world. Okay, so this is a video that I found on YouTube. I don't own the rights to this video. I just decided to post it because it's an awesome resource. So I'm going to play the video for you guys so you can see it. I think it's great. It's very nicely done. And it will explain why teachers share what they use Skype inside the classroom. Let's watch.
Early on, our global experiences were very analog. The light bulb just kind of went on, and I said, you know, what if there was a class somewhere else that we could talk to? What if there was a scientist that was, you know, learning and studying the same things that my students are learning? How awesome would it be to connect my students to that and have them not just read about science, but actually be scientists and work alongside a scientist who could share their research with them?
How many times are you going to see a baby penguin? My kids have. How many times do you get to go see, you know, the tarpon? My kids have. They have that ability to talk to whoever they need to talk to find the results and find the ideas that others have.
It's more than just engagement. It's more than just passion. It's passion for learning.
I've told the kids this many times in the past, that the greatest gift you can have leaving this classroom is to walk away having curiosity about things, wondering about things, questioning things, because that's what makes you invested in life and learning. I can't imagine teaching in a classroom with four walls from a textbook. It's just much, much more than that.
And not only do I see the scientific and the important educational value of it, I do see how it affects them as humans.
My students became lifelong learners because they understood the power of using learning to affect real change in the world.
That's why I Skype, because I can take them, I can make them see the possibilities that I don't think I would be able to if I didn't have it.
I have letters to prove it and conversations I've had with parents where if they felt like their child woke up and all of a sudden really developed a natural interest in the world and what was happening within it.
Skype brings all of it together. It's engaging, and it also makes them passionate about learning more. And that's really the magic zone where you want to be as a teacher.
Okay, so I hope you guys actually enjoyed that video. I think it's very heartwarming. It's very heartfelt. And it goes a little bit, you know, like I said, into detail on why teachers like to use Skype in the classroom. So it's just not me talking about how cool Skype is to use in the classroom or to use for anything. It just has a lot of things to deal with. Okay, so the last thing that I want to do is actually thank you guys for watching my presentation. If you do like my presentations, just make sure to give it a thumbs up. There you have my full name. You have my email if you guys want to get in contact or ask any questions about this presentation. Like I said, thank you guys so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you like. This is also for my class. So if my class wants to go on the discussion board and kind of give their little inputs and comments about my video, go right ahead. Feel free to do so. So again, guys, let's learn how to use collaborative tools in the classroom. I think they're very important, and I think it's just awesome. Guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.